Good morning, dear hearts. We are on lesson 150, the last one in our fourth review. Congratulations, we've made it this far together. And for one more time, I'm going to say, my mind holds only what I think with God. I'm also going to say, please subscribe. But I'm going to be saying, my mind holds only what I think with God several more times for this lesson. Anyway, so we have two lessons. And we must always remember that in truth, our mind can only hold the thoughts that we think with God, because those are the only thoughts that are real and true. Also, we must remember that our mind only holds what we think with God because we are part of God's mind. So we cannot think apart from God, because we can never be apart from God. This is our reality with the big R. This is our truth. Our mind in truth is completely whole and completely holy, as God's mind is. Remember lesson 35, my mind is part of God's. I am very holy and God is in everything I see because God is in my mind. Lesson 30, there is this repetition of ideas, but going a little bit deeper with them, more expansive, that we experience throughout the workbook. The first 50 lessons, we will find echoes of them, remember that word for tomorrow, within subsequent lessons. And this main idea for this review, that my mind holds only what I think with God, certainly proves that to be real and true. I will accept atonement for myself. I will remember the at-one-ment, atonement, salvation, two of the words that are prominent in today's review lessons, are two words that can trigger, and we have throughout the workbook so far substituted them with other words. If they are meaningful, they hold the same meaning, and they are perhaps easier to understand. They give more clarification for some. So I will remember my freedom for myself. I will remember atonement. I will remember that I am truly at one for myself. I will remember who I really am. Let me remember I am one with God, one of our previous review lessons. I will remember and I will accept that. I will accept the truth of who I am, because if I do not accept the truth of who I am, then I, in truth, will not be able to think with the mind of God. I will not, in truth, be able to understand the difference between truth and illusions. I must accept the atonement for myself. It is a requirement of a teacher of God to accept the atonement for themselves. The second lesson that we are reviewing is only salvation can be said to cure. We can substitute salvation for forgiveness. Only forgiveness can be said to cure, and that indeed is true, because forgiveness opens up the way for us to heal. As long as I'm holding on to illusions and grievances and condemnations, I cannot heal. My mind cannot be healed, because my mind is going to be preoccupied with thoughts of grievances, thoughts of unforgiveness. So I will accept forgiveness so that I indeed can be cured. I can be healed completely and forever. Not just a little balm, a salve on top of my wound, but I am forever free of all illusions, because that is how indeed I will be healed. I will be cured when I let go of every illusion that I have ever had and realize that they hold nothing for me. They indeed are valueless, and I will not value what is valueless. What I want to do, and I did it in my Friday night class, and I've done it in years past, is to totally and completely link this central idea that my mind holds only what I think with God with each and every one of our review lessons. And you can see that I was bringing in some of our previous review lessons into today's lesson. That is the cohesiveness of this amazing course that we are studying. It links together, it weaves together in our spiritual tapestry in just the most magnificent and perfect way. So listen as I go through all of our review lessons now. That my mind holds only what I think with God, and forgiveness is the key to happiness. I'm going to probably add a few words here and there. My mind holds only what I think with God, and forgiveness will offer me everything that I want. And my mind holds only what I think with God, and I thank my Father for this gift to me. And my mind holds only what I think with God, so let me remember that I am indeed one with God. My mind holds only what I think with God, and in quiet I will receive God's word today. And my mind holds only what I think with God, and all that I give in truth is given to myself. My mind holds only what I think with God, and there is no love but God's. My mind holds only what I think with God, and the world I see holds nothing that I want. My mind holds only what I think with God, and beyond this world there is a world I want, but my mind holds only what I think with God, so it is impossible to see two worlds. My mind holds only what I think with God, and no one can fail who seeks to reach the truth. My mind holds only what I think with God, so I will loose this world from all that I thought it was. My mind holds only what I think with God, and I will not value what is valueless, because my mind holds only what I think with God, so let me perceive forgiveness as it is in truth. My mind holds only what I think with God, and if I defend myself, I am attacked. And my mind holds only what I think with God, and sickness is a defense against the truth. My mind holds only what I think with God, and when I'm healed, I am not healed alone. My mind holds only what I think with God, and heaven is the decision that I must make today. My mind holds only what I think with God, and I will accept atonement at one meant for myself and for my brothers as well. And my mind holds only what I think with God, and only salvation, only forgiveness can in truth be said to cure. And that's our review number 4, complete and whole and holy. And tomorrow we begin new lessons. So please like, please share, please subscribe, please smile. Please smile at your accomplishment that we are here together doing this, that now we only have the same mind as God and we have the same mind of God together. So smile, breathe in, release everything, and be ready for new ideas to come and enter into our holy minds. Namaste.